All right, got another issue here. I don't have a puller that fits this engine, so I've got to make one to pull the crankshaft. So I'm cutting three pieces of rod, 5/16 rod, and I'm going to thread that at 8 millimeter .125. And by the way, I found out what the screws were that had the washers on them. That's where the bolts go in for the puller. So they evidently didn't want to mess up those threads at the top, which kind of did anyway a little bit. I had to chase them a little, but we'll make it work. So I'm going to cut these rods, then I'm going to cut a piece of 4.5 inch solid, and I'll have to drill holes in it for the rods to go through and weld a nut in it to make the puller. So stand by and we'll get some of this done right away here. I've already got two of these cuts, so I'm doing the last one here. Always something. I'm sure most of you would agree. Actually, before I cut that, I'm going to face it on the lathe. Good enough for facing operation. We've got it faced off. While we've got it in here, we're going to go ahead and drill a hole in the middle of it. I'm going to run a 1/2 inch puller bolt in the middle. So I'm going to, let's see, this is 27/64 is the tap for 1/2 inch 13 thread. So we're going to drill a hole for that. lot harder material than I need for this. That's what I got. This is 4140. It's pretty tough to drill. A piece of mild steel would have been just fine. Tough chip. Better take the burr off the end of it here a little bit. Our wafer for the top. Yeah. three of these bolts that are used to pull on that little wafer that we made earlier. I was going to go to the hardware store and just get a couple bolts, or three bolts, but I knew they wouldn't have them. We don't have stuff like that around here. They have a few metric fasteners, but nothing to really speak of in length. Especially, it seems like the 125, you know, 1.25 thread pitch is real hard to come by. That's a motorcycle thing, not a, you know, an 8mm bolt in automotive, and probably any other thing would be a 1.50. So I just got some 5/16 coal roll. We'll make them. Really only has to be 8mm where it goes into the engine case, but why get another die out? There's our three bolts. Deburn the threads a little bit. All right, now we'll get this center hole tapped. Putting a little centering point on the through bolt. There's our three cutouts for the bolts that pull from the case or separate the case. Let me get it cleaned up. All right, here we are with it installed, and looks like it's pulling it apart. I think it'll work. I think I'm gonna give it up for tonight and start fresh in the morning. So there we are, a puller for our case separator. All right, let's see if we can get this thing apart now. Looks like it's starting to split okay. Try to keep everything in the right case. Gasket's kind of holding us up there. I think we're crankshaft's all out anyway. Take our tool off. That goes there. Ooh, that's for the balls for the low high. And we gotta make sure that goes that way there. Seeing any issues right now. So I'm anxious to see what the seal looks like on the crankshaft, because I think that's where my problem is. Not sure whether that's gonna wanna come out directly or not. Give her a tap. Yep, get that out. I think that's where it was going. All right. Guess we'll evaluate what we need and see if we can find any of it. So there we go, we're apart. We built the tool to separate the cases with, and we've got it apart. So on with the journey, I guess. Thanks for hanging out with me.